Hello guys, welcome to LT Models. I decided to do another video updates on this little gem right here. This is the Tamiya's 1/72nd scale of the Stormovik, the IL-2. This is a Russian aircraft. Really, really great kit for what I read on the reviews and stuff. This is gonna be a shelf queen. You know, modelers use the term shelf queen when you start a project and for X or Y reason you put it aside on your shelf and you just, you know, time goes by because whether you got, you know, distracted with another kid or you just lost your mojo. In this case, the reason why I started the kit was because, well, it had good reviews. I was really excited. I wanted to build it right away. But the reason why I stopped was because Edward had made all kinds of aftermarket for it. So you guys could see here, I got the mask for it. Yeah. Over here in the Post-it, I have the interior set, you know, the zoom set, the brassing wheels, exhaust and all that stuff. I believe they have also the Big Sin set, which I'll put all the info and stuff. So that's why I stopped. And then when I wanted to get back at it, I just got distracted with some other stuff in life and in general. If you guys want to watch a review on this, I recommend, you know, YouTube and I believe Brett Green. Those he does both reviews of the 1/72nd and the 1/48th scale, which is pretty much just the same kit, just scaled down on the 1/72nd scale. It's a great kit for what I read. I've had done shelf queens before. Let me show you guys. Whoa. Let me show you guys this. Okay, this is the Edward kit of the Hellcat, and I'll put a picture up on the video. This was a shelf queen, and there's a modeler by the name of Diego Quijano who built a Hellcat, the same exact kit. And when I saw his build, I was just so impressed with it. And I wanted to build it, you know, because his experience with it was very, very positive. I weathered the crud out of it, as you guys could see. You know, did some smoke, you know, staining there, which came out really good. I'll put pictures of it, you know, so you guys could take a look at it. This is a profi pack, so it came out with, you know, comes with photo etch and all that stuff. You really don't need anything, but it's a great kit. Excuse me. Sorry. It's a great kit, and I was able to finish it. And because of this, I remember that there was a kit that I started and I never finished it, and this was it. So give me just 1 second. I don't want to drop this thing. So this is why I started this, and I decided, you know what, let me just finish it. So what I've done so far is pretty much, I think it's step number 3. It's pretty much the cockpit, okay? And I decided not to use any aftermarket. The only aftermarket I'm gonna use is the mask, and that's it. It's pretty decent. You know, it's a Tamiya kit. You really are gonna have a good time building it. As you guys can see, it's in sub assemblies. It's been painted. It's been, it hasn't been weathered yet, as you guys can see here. I don't know how well you're gonna be able to see this, but you know, it has a decal. There's the decal, you know, a little coat of matte varnish, and you should be able to get rid of that silver right there. really, really nice kit, very, very basic. What else? Forgive me for the noise. There's B-2 bombers flying today over Lancaster. I live right next door to Edwards Air Force Base, so they're doing some testing today. So you might be able to hear them, maybe not, but that's what you're hearing on the background. As far as the cockpit colors go, I go by the instructions, and for what I've seen online, it seems like they got it right. I used XF22, which is the RLM gray. I believe it's RLM02. I'm not sure. So I'm gonna go with that. Forgive me if I'm saying a lot, but it's been a while since I've done videos. So just follow me, and you know my style. I do video updates, and I hope you guys follow along. It should be a nice and quick build. I'm gonna concentrate a little bit on the weathering on this. I'm not gonna go too crazy with it. I wanna be able to enter it on the out of the box category in my next contest. I'm also gonna try to do for the first time the wiring for the antennas. I've never done that in 1/72 scale. So I'll try that with some Easy Line, and yeah, hope you guys join me. And as always, thank you guys very much for all the comments and stuff. And yeah, so happy modeling, guys, and I'll see you guys on my next video. Bye-bye.